difference does it make? We've got each other, Ben.
You had it all and you threw it away!
You bastard! What? You 14-carat bastard!
I thought you were my best friend. Best I ever had, Ben.
What's this all about?
You know damn well what this is about.
You want to screw around with Sally, take her dancing maybe, but that's all, right?
I don't understand.
Yes, you do.
That's all, right, Ben?
She's a sweet kid, but that's where it stops.
What did you do to her?
You're a goddamn liar!
Screw you.
It's getting late, Ben. You should go. You're not in love with Sally. Boy, you take the cake.
Oh. Have you told me to go with you?
I never said I love you. Did I?
Now, if you really love me.
Love you, yes, I love you.
I never meant to hurt you, Sally.
Then why not?
I'm sorry, but it was finished years ago.
You really love me, don't you, kid?
Oh, with all my heart, buddy.
That's a lie.
Please, Ben, I'd like to go now.
Ben ran out and I was there, that's all it was.
So what a reason am I cheap, is that it? I'm not good enough!
You put your goddamn feet.
No, don't leave me, Ben!
You fool!
I want a baby, Ben!
You let her hide!
Here it is in a different version.
What will tomorrow bring? The pundits query.
it be cheery?
Will it be sad?
Will it be Burton Spring or Harakiri?
Don't worry, dearie.
Don't worry, lad.
I'll have our future suit your whim, the ship preferred. This thing together, aren't you glad? Each day from now will be the best day you ever had. You're gonna love tomorrow. You're gonna be with me. You're gonna love tomorrow. I'm giving you my personal guarantee.
It's eternaloo to sorrow and fairly well on we.
Bye bye.
You gotta love tomorrow. As long as your tomorrow is spent with me. Today
was perfectly perfect, you say. Well, don't go away. Cause if you think you like today, you're gonna love tomorrow. Stick around and see. And if you love tomorrow, then think of how it's gonna be. Tomorrow's what you're gonna have a lifetime of with me. Sally, dear, now that we're man and wife, I will do wonders to make your life soul-stirring and free of care.
Every night, I'll concede. Furthermore, dear, should your ego need all the stirring, I'll do my share.
Though I'll try my utmost to seem never proud,
and though I'll try to cut most of our expenses down,
I've seen traits I warn you to which you have objections.
Try to have a cornucopia of
imperfections.
I may burn the toast.
Oh well, I may make a rotten host.
Do tell.
But no matter what goes wrong, love will see us through to something better comes along. I may vex your host.
Okay, I may interrupt your joke.
You may, but if I come on too strong, love will see us through to something better comes along. I may play cards all night and come home at three.
Just
leave a light on the board for me. Well, nobody's perfect. I may charm.
Please do. I may clutter up the place.
Me too.
But the minute we embrace, those old streets on, dear, thou seest through the something better comes along.
This is a disaster. I mean, I
don't care.
Girls, then,
Sally,
you're gonna learn tomorrow. Oh, well, I may be a kind of bee. No matter what goes wrong, I'm glad to see my search is on the
bedroom
tomorrow. I may vex.
You should have looked so okay. I may
end up
well on.
You may,
if I
kind
of love to struggle,
trouble seems to be so bad.
Today,
play cards all night and come on.
You say, don't go all the way.
Cause if you think you'll like it today, you're gonna love tomorrow. Stick around and see. But if you love tomorrow, then think of how it's gonna be.
Tomorrow's what you're gonna have, and Monday's what you're gonna have, and April's what you're gonna have, and love's what you're gonna have, and love's what you're gonna have.
And the next part of the fantasy sequence from Follies.
talk to friends, I think about them, and do they know? It's like I'm losing my mind. All afternoon doing every little chore, the thought of you stays behind. Sometimes I stand in the middle of the floor, not going.
I was not going on the bus, not with you all to take with you to take to New York tomorrow. And they're telling you
to think about spend sleepless nights to think about you said you loved.
Nothing at all. Okay, thanks.
Okay.
Or were you just being
again, another one of the great fantasy sequences and follies. These poor women, and this is Bernadette Peters introducing Danny Burstyn in the Buddy's Folly segment.
Please.
I've got those dots. Why don't you love me? Oh, you do. I'll see you later. Blues. That long as you ignore me, you're the only thing that matters. Feeling. That if I'm good enough for you, you're not good enough. And thank you for the present, but what's wrong with it, stuff? Those don't come any closer, cause you know how much I love you. Feelings. Those tell me that you love me. Oh, you did. I gotta run now. Blues. Margie? She says she really loves me.
I love you.
She says she really cares. She says that I'm her hero. She says I'm perfect, she swears.
You're perfect!
Damn it!
She says that if we parted.
She says
that she'd be sick. She says she's mine forever. She says, I gotta get out of here quick.
I love you!
whisper how I'm better than I think, but what do you know? Dad, why do you keep telling me I stink when I adore you? Feelings that say I'm all the world to you, you're out of your mind. I know there's someone else and I could kiss your behind. Those you say I'm terrific, but your taste was always rotten. Feeling. No, go away, I need you. Come to me, I'll kill you. Darling, I'll do anything to keep you with me till you tell me that you love me. Oh, you did, now beat it, will you? Sally? She says she loves another.
Another.
She says a fella she prefers.
First friend.
She says that he's her idol.
Idol, 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 idol.
She says ideal, she avers.
You deal, lover.
She says that anybody.
Buddy, blah.
She says would suit her more than I.
Ay, ay, ay.
She says that I'm a washout.
A washout.
She says I love her so much I could die. Good enough for you, you're not good enough.
No.
Thank you for the present, but what's wrong with it stuff?
No.
Don't come any closer, cause you know how much I love you. Feeling. Those if you will, then I can't. If you don't, then I gotta give it to me. I don't want it. If you won't, I gotta have it. I love wrong, right, yes, no, black, white. Oh, you do, I'll see you later.
And then another great moment from Follies. The whole dream sequence situation, the way the Follies interplayed ghosts and reality throughout, is what makes Follies so incredibly complex and special.
Some like to sink and think in their easy chairs. Of all the things they've risen above, some like to be profound by reading Proust and Pound. Me like to live, me like to laugh, me like to love. Success is swell and success is sweet, but every height has a drop. The less achievement, the less defeat. What's the point of shoving your way to the top? Living, laughing, loving, you're never a flop. Soon when the walls are crumbling.
Yes!
Don't give up the ship.
No!
Learn how to laugh and how to love and how to live. That's my tip.
This gives you a great sense. And then Nine, the wonderful musical about a film director who's having a midlife crisis in all the women in his life who have come to make him crazy as he's melting down all over. What he thinks back, the only other person in the musical that's not a woman is his own alter ego when he was nine. And this nine-year-old meeting a prostitute on the beach in Italy who's teaching him about women.
Scallion, when you hold me down. sentimental. Go ahead and try to give my cheek a pat, but be daring and uncaring. When you pinch me, try to pinch me where there's fat.
City of Angels is another musical, the story of a writer in Hollywood who's trying to finish a script. He writes film noir, a story about a detective in 1940s Hollywood, and the detective becomes his alter ego, actually becoming the voice for himself. He's having a problem with his love life, and it's these characters in the movie.
This year's second nominated musical.
Here it goes.
To this year's second nominated musical, City of Angels. The book is by Larry Gelbhardt. The score is by Cy Coleman and David Zippel. City of Angels is Los Angeles, as if you didn't know.
In the City of Angels.
City of Angels takes us back in black and white and glorious color to the Hollywood of the 40s, where a novelist named Stein turns one of his books into a screenplay about a private eye named Stone.
Alora Kingsley. She had the kind of face a man could hang a dream on, a body that made the Venus de Milo look all thumbs, and only the floor kept her legs from going on.
My money's on you, Mr. Stone. You look like the kind of man who can get the job done.
The woman in Stein's life? His wife, Gabby. For one.
You don't really have to go back to New York, Gab.
Beats hanging around watching you sell out.
I'll call.
I'd rather you wrote anything but what you're writing.
What you don't know about women,
what you don't know about women,
could fill a shelf of books. You are the type of man who looks for understanding lovers, but never understands the girl who lies beneath the covers. You only have to open up your mouth to show what you don't know.
You don't know
about women.
You think what I don't know will not hurt me, but you don't know.
Discretion.
No check about heartache.
Let them say what you're feeling.
Only wink at commitment.
You're running low on emotion.
What you don't know about women.
It's only a drop in the ocean.
Next to what you don't know about me.
You are an evil little liking on ladies I love, but you can't see. What you don't know about women is frightening, and you don't know nothing about.
You serious? You really gonna make those changes? You are selling out. I would not believe it.
You wouldn't believe it? Is that what you said? You wouldn't believe it?
You
are some gumshoe. You just don't think. Well, get this dumb gumshoe. You come from my inkwell.
You are so thick. You eat, breathe, sleep fiction. I'm your meal ticket. Knee deep in cheap fiction.
You gloating ignoramus, you haven't any shame.
Hey, I'm a famous Seamus, and most people don't know your name. You're nothing without me, a no one who'd go undefined. You wouldn't exist, you'd never be missed. I tell you, you're out of my mind. A show-off, a blowhard. You're equal parts hot air and cold. And no one would doubt me without me. You're nothing.
Wait. This is Hollywood.
Gotta have a happy ending, right?
You read my mind.
I am your mind. Chances and breaks.
I'm nowhere without you.
Without you is where I went wrong.
The script calls for fusing and using our smarts. And greatness can come of the sum of our parts. But now on, I'm with you, and with you is where I be.
Kiss of the Spider Woman is another musical that used fantasy to propel the story. Written by Kandra Neb, the story of two convicts sharing a cell during the Chilean Civil War, and they would occupy their mind by thinking about this movie star who was very big in Chile at the time. Kiss of the Spider Woman is rough stuff, I mean, about these two prisoners and the relationship that they develop, but this gives you a sense.
My mother died, my mother had to work nights as an usherette in a cinema. She never complained. I, of course, adored it. It was a fabulous cinema. It had Egyptian decor. Since there was no one to look after me, she took me with her when she went to work. And she sat me in the front row. That's when I first saw Maya Rawl. Shut up, you fool. Listen. Oh, I don't hear what I don't want to hear.
They're bringing a prisoner back from interrogation.
They're going to make us look at him to frighten us.
Well, I look. But I don't see. Deaf, dumb, and blind. You take my advice, Mr. Revolutionary.
When you feel you've gone to hell in a handbasket, and the world in which you dwell's no paradise,
I've some counsel I can give. You need but ask it. I'm so very glad to share this good advice. You've got to learn how not to be where you are. The more you face the reality, the more you scar. So close your eyes and you can be a movie star. Why must you stay where you are? You've got to learn how not to see what you see. The slice of hell you call your life is harsh and mean. So why not lie beside me on a movie screen? Why must you see what you've seen? And if you find that you land in jail, a little fantasy will not fail. It's just as simple as ABC. Come on here.
And one last musical written by Kandra Nebb, the made-up story about a pilot who really doesn't exist except in the mind of the people who are at this dance marathon, a great number from Steel Pier.
Live on the world-famous Steel Pier, it's the 1933 Atlantic City Dance Marathon. I'm your host, Mick Hamilton, and in just a few moments, this glorious marathon will get underway. And look who's just signed up. It's Lindy's lovebird, Miss Rita Racine, and her partner, Flyboy Bill Kelly. And hey, isn't that sizzling Shelby Stevens? Folks, even though times are tough beyond that boardwalk, you can bet you'll find a high-flying world of romance and dreams right here on the Steel Pier.
I saw party, why don't you come? Canton Folders. Dance, dance your blues off, tap bad news off, shag your shoes off, and worries walks away. Away. When you feel an anger deep inside that smolders, dance, 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 mister. Everybody dance, 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 dance. That's right, boys, give me some sass.
Shut down! Get out of here, you nut!
Businessmen, do you like what you see? Sponsor your favorites. They get your vote of confidence. You get their backs. And while you're deciding just who's going to be your sweet patootie, why not consider a couple numbers 17? Go on now, let that cat meow.
Well, I hope y'all enjoyed a little bit of the fantasies today. I know there were some chats that came up, and let me look and see. I guess there was a sound problem today. I really, I don't know why, but in any event, I guess that can happen. The original Mutthole in Fiddler on the Roof was Leonard Fry, and Bert Convy was the original Perchick. I don't understand why there's a problem with the sound. I apologize. I'll try to figure it out for next week. And, you know, I'm sorry if there was any problem there with the sound. Anyway, everybody have a great day. See you next Friday, as always. And I'm sorry if you heard my phone conversation. I'll be really honest. I have a theater trip going tomorrow, and the bus company called me with a problem. A little frustrating. So sorry if you heard me. I tried to walk to another room. I apologize. Thanks, all, everybody. Take care.